Hey, I'm Terry G. Thanks a lot for stopping by and watching my video. If you could take a second, can you please subscribe to my channel? I'd really appreciate it. Again, thanks a lot for stopping by. You know, the first couple of days of this week, I fell into these old patterns of my old life. And that happens in sobriety, doesn't it? We sort of go along with our lives. Everything's going great for us. Then something happens in life, was stressful or negative or makes us happy, and we slip back into this negative behavior. And that's what happened to me this week. It wasn't so much behavior, it was more like a thought pattern. What happens to me a lot of, and I really got to keep an eye on it, is the way I talk to myself when I make a mistake or when I screw up. I've had big issues with anger, resentment, feeling hurt, feeling oversensitive, you know, not taking well the criticism. I've had big issues around that area, and it caused me a lot of pain and crazy behavior and crazy things I did over my anger, over resentment, you know, unable to take criticism. And early this week, it happened to me. I screwed up, I was criticized, and I got angry, and I sort of blew my moral compass, or, you know, didn't live up to my expectations, whatever it was. But what happens when that happens in my sobriety is that I take out the emotional baseball bat. I start beating the shit out of myself emotionally in my mind. No one knows what's going on except me. You're no good, Terry. You're never going to get over this. Your relationship is going to suffer. You're going to screw it up, Terry. You're going to do all these things that are going to make your life miserable. And I just keep talking like that to myself. Whoosh, whoosh. All this negative self-talk when I feel that I have failed myself or people around me. You know, when I work so hard to be a better person, work so hard at my sobriety, work so hard about my character defects, and then they come out and I show myself like in a negative way, and I withdraw within myself like crazy. I go right inside myself and I start pounding the shit out of myself. And you know something? That has no purpose in my life right now. It's an old habit. I do it. I think sometimes I get comfort over doing, well, you know, when I do it. But I also feel that sometimes I justify it. You know, if I can make myself feel really bad for doing something that was not morally correct in my eyes, or not living up to my expectations of the program or the people around me, or hurting people I love, or doing a behavior that's not really normal in my everyday life, it really, really gets to me, and I pound the living shit out of myself. I don't know, can you identify with that? Can you identify with that negative self-talk, that negative talk when we make a mistake in our lives? Because if you can, you're not alone. A lot of people, not just in recovery programs, do it. They really do. They're really hard on themselves. It's like getting in the fighting ring with Mike Tyson and just beating the living shit out of myself. I usually say something like this: if somebody talked to me the way I talk to myself, I would beat the crap out of them. I'm abusive to myself. I become abusive in my thinking. I mean, not my thinking, in the words I use against myself. And you know something? That's old behavior. That has no real good in anybody's life, and especially in a recovering alcoholic's life, because that can lead us back to the drink to get emotional relief. That can lead us back out there, that vicious loop of negative punishment, negative self-beating our shit out of ourselves over time. It lasted for me about 48 hours. I felt irritated at the end, agitated. I felt angry. I was very tired. I wasn't eating properly. I was doing all this behavior that wasn't normal. I was snotty to my girlfriend. You know, it wasn't that good. But you know, most of the time I don't even go there. Sometimes I get caught up like that, but most of the time I don't go there. Because in the program, when we make mistakes in our lives, let me tell you something, making mistakes is a very big part of life. If you're not making mistakes, you're not living. You're really not. A guy told me, a psychiatrist once told me, if you're not, the only people who don't make mistakes are the ones in the graveyard. Because making mistakes or failing in life, you know, as we move forward, is a part of life. It's a lesson to be learned, but to move on in life. My thinking in early recovery, and when I revert to those days where the negative self-talk, is what's basically going on is that I'm not living up to my expectations. I'm not saying to myself the one line that it says in 12-step program, spiritual progress, not spiritual perfection. We, including myself, are all a works in progress. We're going to make mistakes when it comes to when we're involved with people, places, and things. We're going to make mistakes, but we don't have to sit there and ruminate about it and pound the shit out of ourselves. You know, the world is not, there's not right and wrong in the world. There's right and wrong in the world, but there's a lot of gray. There's a lot of gray in the world. And thinking that there's a lot of gray in the world and get rid of right and wrong, or, you know, bad person, good person attitude, really starts to help you develop a more easier view about yourself, a more forgiving view about yourself. Talking to yourself like you're your best friend. If your friend came up to you and asked you, told you about a problem they were having, the same sort of problem that you're having, you would give them much different advice, a more loving, caring advice you would give them, but you wouldn't give it to yourself. And I don't give it to myself sometimes. I don't treat myself like I love myself, or don't treat myself like I'm my best friend. I treat myself like I'm my worst enemy. So in life, there's a lot of gray. There really is. There's reasons why things happen. It's our upbringing. Maybe we're stressed out. Maybe we feel afraid. Maybe we feel hurt. There's a lot of reasons why we act out sometimes, why we snap. Sometimes we can be too tired. And that's what happened. I was too tired. I showed anger. I flipped out, basically. You know? So there's a lot of explanations. I can't even pronounce that word. There's a lot of things that occur in one's life that we have to take into consideration, because we're only human beings. We're not perfect. That's what makes us so beautiful, that we're not perfect. And we're going to make mistakes, but we got to stop this pounding on ourselves. And I'll tell you something that's a fact. If you run into a situation that you blew your moral compass, or you didn't live up to your expectations, or you flipped out because somebody criticized you, and you sit there and you pound on yourself, it doesn't help the situation. It really doesn't. You can't evaluate the situation accordingly if you're constantly pounding on yourself or taking out the emotional baseball bat. You can do that if you want, but you need to go back and sort of analyze it or do a little step work on that to find out why you behave like that. And maybe next time you can make a change on that behavior, that situation. I know that's what I do. Sometimes I just don't go around the people. Maybe it's just simply getting some more sleep. Maybe it's simply I'm really stressed out. Like last week, I was totally overwhelmed doing renovations on my cottage, working on my house, going to work, doing Zoom meetings, talking to people in 12-step programs, dinner, supper, breakfast, all those things, all those life things. It catches up with you sometimes, and we make mistakes during all those stressful events. So we need to go easy on ourselves. Easy does it. Keep it simple. First things first. Reach out, talk to somebody in the program. Then just sit down when you make a mistake and have a little, inventory on it. Think back of what happened and what you can do to improve your life, what you can do to improve your situation. Not sit there and beat the living crap out of yourself, because that's the old you. That's the old me talking to me. That's the old me. That's the drinking me when I was out there and I was a total screw up. That's the old me talking to Terry G in those moments. It comes up. It doesn't happen as often, but it does happen. It does happen. And what are we going to do about it? We're going to stand up. We're going to analyze it. We're going to learn to love ourselves, have some techniques that can sort of get us away from that thinking. Go to a meeting, go to a Zoom meeting, talk to people in the program, pray, meditate, tell somebody, don't isolate, don't stay by yourself, get active, get involved, help someone else. There's lots you can do to get you out of that negative mindset. There's a lot you can do, but you need to take action. You need to do it. Okay. So I hope you found this video helpful, because this is a big deal for me. This kind of stuff, this negative, beating the hell out of myself emotionally. It's a great big deal to me, because I've done it tons in my life, and it's taken a lot of work for me to get away from those habits. But sometimes it happens and I have to go through it and work through it, but I learn again from it. I learn from that lesson and I analyze the situation, and next time I try and do better in that situation. Those times that we make mistakes or we feel like failures, they're usually opportunities in disguise. They're not meant for us to hammer ourselves. Be forgiving, love yourself, treat yourself like your own best friend. Talk to yourself like you would talk to your buddy in the same situation, okay? Thanks a lot for stopping by. My name is Terry G. This is an alcohol-free life channel where we learn to live sober one day at a time, okay? I hope you're all doing well out there. The pandemic here in Ottawa is sort of settling down a little bit. You know, things are opening up. Life is getting busy again, okay? I hope you all stay safe. Stay sober, and I'll see you next time. Thanks for stopping by, and God bless. Peace and out. Bye-bye.